Hi, welcome back to our channel. In this video, I will follow up the previous one about bolt and nut, but for this one, it will be about containers and screw cap. Okay, so screw cap containers usually have three common characteristics for the thread mechanism. If you have one laying around, just take and then open and let's take a look at how the thread was designed. Okay. First, they are usually have a wider pitch than the thread width itself. So, for example, if the thread size is 2 mm, then maybe it will have thread pitch 4 mm. The second characteristic is that the thread count is usually small, 1, 2, or 3. So, for example, if the thread count or the rotation is more than 5, you can imagine you want to take a gem out of the jar and you have to unscrew 10 full rotation, it will be troublesome. So that's why they designed maybe only 1, 2, or 3 thread rotation. And then for the third characteristic is that the thread will not go all the way up or all the way down like in this picture. So it will go up to this point and still has some space above, okay? And then also for this one only goes to this point and still have some space below. Now I will start by clicking file, new, design. Okay, for this one I will draw for the Z and X axis first. So in that case I will click this one, 3D mode. Okay, and then I will click this one, the green button. For this cube, it will show here Z and X, and then I will click this one, the sketch mode again, and then click here. So now I will sketch at the Z and X axis. Okay, we will make a container for this tutorial. We will make 50 millimeters in diameter and 50 millimeters height. So I will click this one, rectangle, and then I will draw a rectangle with 50 millimeters and 50 millimeters like this. Okay, now I will click this one, the offset curve, and then click for this, double click. Okay, I will add thickness. In this case, I will add 1.6. So it will be the thickness of the container. I will cut this one to become the cap and the base. So I'm going to make a rectangle here. So, okay, starting from here, I'm going to make a 10 millimeters height here. Okay, so now I have this shape, and then I will add another 0.2, which will be the space or the gap from the cap to the base. So I will type in 0.2. okay, I will click select to make it easy to look at now, and then next I will add some space between the cap and the base for the thread position. So in that case, I will click this one, the rectangle again, okay, and then click here, up to here, 10 millimeters, with thickness 1.6. So it will be the thread size that we are using. And then I will make another one with 1.6. It will be the thickness of the inner wall for the container. Okay, now I will cut this top one. I should make the rectangle longer so it should touch this bottom line. Wait the moment. Okay, so the width itself is 1.6. okay, done. And I will need to add some gap here, so this will be 0.2 and the width is 1.6, like this. And then one more thing to add is the this one. So it will be the inner side of the container. And this one, 135 degrees. So we don't have to use any support to print the inner side of the container. Okay. Like this. Maybe it's a bit difficult to follow now, but after you see the area result, it will be easier to understand. So, okay. Now I will add another rectangle here to show the middle position for this object. So it should be at 26.6, this one. So if you see this triangle, it should be there. Okay, now I will click this one, 3D mode. This is how the cross-sectional view will looks like. And now I will delete areas that we don't need. So first I will click this one, select, and then I will click here and press delete, and then click here, press delete, and then this one, the gap, and then for this one I will click here, delete, click here, also delete this one also, and this one. So we can see that this is the basic shape for the cross-sectional view, and we will change, or we will modify this cross-sectional view and extrude to become a 3D container. So I will select these areas, press Ctrl and then select this area, and then click this one, pull, click this one, revolve, okay, click this one, add, and then click this line, which is the center or the middle of this cross-sectional view design, and then I will click this one, the full pull. Wait a moment, let me zoom out so we can see what happens. Okay, so it will become this container, and after that I will click this one, surface, and then press delete, so it will be more simple now. Now if I click here and then press X or click this icon, we can see this cross-sectional view. Now we will continue with adding the thread, and to do that we will again, we will click this one, sketch mode. Okay, I will start from this side, and then first we will make the thread for the cap, which should be lower than the thread of the container or the base. So now I will click this one, line, and then starting from here, so we will still have this space at the bottom, so not the thread is not going all the way to the end of the cap. So I will click here and then 60 degrees, and I will type in 1.6. okay, same way at this direction, so 1.6 and 60 degrees, and then we will add a rectangle here to ensure the extrusion process, so like this. Okay, and then I will make the shape for the thread of the container base, so, or the container case. I'll click this one, line, and then make this guiding line, so I can start from this one to make the similar rectangle, and the length is the same, 1.6, and then from this point again 1.6, and then this one is 1 millimeter, so it will become a rectangle, and then this one is 1.6, then goes here 1 millimeter. Okay, now I will click select, and I will select this one, the guiding line that we have just used, and it's not necessary anymore, so I will press delete. Okay, now we have this shape, but there is still something that we need to do now, is to add more allowance for the thread design. So if we see this point or this peak of the thread is very close to this wall, so we will cut and give some space or add some crest to the thread design. So in that case, I will click this one, the 3-point rectangle, and first I will cut, or I will make the cutting for this thread. I'll click here, and then I will type in 0.4. so we will use this line to cut this thread. And then again for the other side with similar method, it doesn't have to be precise for this first 2 point, but we need to make sure that this thickness, or this will be the cap, is as we want. So in this case, I want it 0.4. okay, click this one, select, and now we will hide the two solids, which was the cap and the base. So now we have this shape, and I will click in this one, 3D mode. So now we have this area or surface, and we will delete the area that we don't need. So I will click here and press delete. This one also already cut, so no need for that one. Here also, and here and here. So we have these two thread shape. You can actually add some more touch for this design, maybe some curve here using radius and so on, but for this one I will just use like this. And then now I will click here and then press F to make the shape more simple, and then also click here and press F. Okay, now we have these two basic shape that we can use to make the thread. And then I will unhide one by one, but now I will start with the maybe from the inner one or for the base one. Okay, I will hide the surface for the cap, so I will just show this one. And then the method is same with the last video, but we have something special here. So I will click this one, pull, and then this one, revolve, and then we click here at the axis, okay, and then add, and then revolve helix. Okay, now the pitch, so the thread size is 1.6 millimeters, if you remember what we have just input for the rectangle. But for the pitch, we will use 3.2, which means the pitch is twice the thread size. Okay, I will click here and then move up, and it will shows like this. And then if we see the height at the table, it shows minus 3.6. So in that case, I will type in minus, and then I release the mouse button, okay, and then type in again 3.4, and then I will press enter. Okay, now I will click this one, select. Now we have this thread for the base, and as you can see, it follows the three characteristics that we explained in the beginning of this video. For the cap, we'll do the similar thing. Let me show the surface to make the thread here. Okay, we will click this one, pull, and then this one, revolve, and I will click this one, add, revolve helix, and then again I will drag or extrude and type in minus 3.4. so the same thing for this thread, it goes like this, so about one full rotation with some extra length here. Okay, now if we take a look at the cross-sectional view, it will become like this. Congratulations, now you can design your own container with screw cap. And anyway, for this design, you can still also improve by adding chamfer to the edges at the top and at the bottom. And I guess that's all for now. If you have any suggestion or idea, please put in the comment below. Don't forget to subscribe. Have fun, stay safe. See you in the next video. Bye.